pivot tables from multiple sheets. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to create pivot tables from multiple sheets or tables in Excel. If you're trying to do this, there are two possible situations. You either have related tables, meaning you have one table that has some identifiers and you have another table that has keys in that second table as well. And basically you want to link these tables together and create some sort of report. Or you have a situation where you have multiple tables on different sheets and they are basically the same columns of data, but you want to put them all together to create one pivot table report. So in this particular example, the columns are not exactly the same in all of the sheets, and I'm going to show you how to handle that too. So let's get started. So let's get started with this one. So on this one, we have this worksheet that has customer IDs. It has stock numbers. Now in customers tab, we have those customer IDs and some data about customers. And then in products, we have stock numbers and some data about those different products. So let's say we want to link all of this together and create a pivot table. So to do this, the first thing I'm going to do is convert all the data that I need for this to an Excel table. So I'll start with this transactions. I'm going to go Control A. We'll go to Insert, Table. We do have headers on top, so these are headers on top. Hit OK. That's going to convert this to a table. If you don't like this design, you can go here and do none, but it's really up to you. And finally, on top left, you want to name this table. So I'm going to call this one transactions. So you can name these anything you like, but you can't have spaces or special characters here. So sometimes people use underscores, that's fine. So I'm just going to call this transactions. Now I'll go to customers. And I'm going to convert this to a table too. So Control A, Insert, Table, has headers, hit OK. Once again, I'll go up here, call this one Customers, hit Enter. And then I'll go to Products, select this one, Control A. Again, Insert, Table, my table has headers, hit OK. And up here, I'm going to call this product. Hit enter. So now I got three tables. So now I'll go to transactions and I'm going to click on the first table, go to insert and click pivot table. And it's going to pick up on that transactions table, as you can see here. And what I'll do here, I'll click on this, add this to data model. So I'm going to hit OK. And basically now it's going to show me this transactions table with all the columns in the table. So for example, now if I take quantity sold and drag it to values, it will give me total quantity sold from that particular table. So if you need actual instructions how to build pivot tables in general, I have a separate video for that. You can watch that. Here, I'm just going to concentrate on this situation with multiple tables. So at this point, I have this active on top here, and I have all. So I'm going to click on this all right here, and here is going to show all the tables that I made. So you can see we have customers, products, transactions. So I'll go here, for example, to products, and from products, I'm going to choose brand column and drag it to rows. And you can see here, it's actually not giving me the accurate numbers. It's just giving me the same grand total for each brand. But right now, if you pay attention here, it gives me this pop-up in yellow, and it's asking to create relationship between these tables. So I'm going to hit create, and I'm going to choose my main table first, transactions, and then I'm going to choose that secondary products table, and then I'm going to show the key column that links those tables, which in this case is going to be stock numbers here and stock numbers in the second table. So I'm going to just define this relationship, hit OK. And there it is. Now this is working. So basically, based on this transaction's stock numbers, we are linking those stock numbers to this products table stock numbers. And now we can create reports by brand. Now, maybe I also want to add this gender for customer to this. So I'm going to go to that same sheet one where the pivot table is. And I'll go to customers table and I'll get gender and drop it in columns. Once again, initially, it's not giving me the accurate amounts, but it's asking me to create relationship. So I'm going to click create. Again, select my main transactions table, then select my secondary customers table and define the key column between those two tables, which is in this case, customer ID. Hit okay. And there it is. So it gives me the breakdown by gender. And apparently in that gender column, we have some blanks. So one of the options here is blank. So if we go to customers and look here, see, we have some blanks. And there you go. So I was able to make a pivot table using three different tables data and interconnect those together and get this done. So I'm going to name this pivot table. Now let's look at the other possibility. So in this one, we have three different tabs. And if you look at these tabs, most of these columns are the same. But if I go to 2021, this one doesn't have category here. So the important part here is that the columns that should be matching should have the same name. So for example, see, it's called date here. If that's the same column here, it should also be called date and so on, date here. So for example, sales here, we also have sales, the same column name and the same column name. So that's important that the columns you actually need, they actually match. So once I have that, once again, I'm gonna start by converting all of these to tables. So I'm gonna go Control A, insert, table. Again, my table has headers, hit okay. And I'll go on top here and I'll name this table. So I'm gonna call this one sales 2020, hit enter. And I'm gonna repeat this for the other two. So I'll click here, Control A, insert table, call this sales 2021. Finally, click on the third one, Control A, insert table. My table has headers. And this one is sales 2022. So now I got three different tables. So once I got three different tables, now I'm gonna establish connection to these tables. So I'm gonna click on the first one here, go to data, and here we're gonna look for this from table range button. If you don't see that button here, you'll find it under get data from other sources from table range. So I'm gonna click on this. It's gonna take a little bit for this to load. So now I'll go close and load two, and click on this only create connection. So I'm creating connection to that table. Now I'm gonna do that for the rest of the tables too. So I'll click on this, click. So here I have the button, so I don't have to do this anymore. So I'll just click directly on the button from table range. And then close and load two, only create connection, and finally this one. And again, close and load two, only create connection. And now I have connections to all my tables. If you have more, you're gonna have to get all of them. So now once I have these three connections, I'm gonna go here under get data and I'm gonna go combine queries. And here we have this option append. And this is gonna show up. Now I got more than two tables, so I'm gonna select three or more tables. You can see all those connections, they show up here. So I'm just gonna add all of them here. And I'm gonna press okay. And that's gonna just combine those tables to one combined data. And you can see because one of them doesn't have any category, it's just null here. So I'll just name this here instead of append, I'll just call combined data, hit enter. And now I'm gonna go close on load, and again, close on load too. And right here, I'm gonna do pivot table report. So we'll do okay. So now we're creating a pivot table report from that combined data. So I should be able to now drag sales and then pick another column like region. And we have our total per region. I'll right click, do number format, currency to do some formatting here. So now I got combined totals from this three different years of data right here. And we should be able to also just drop the date in here so we can see those are those different years now combined together, and we get our totals. Now going forward, if you decide you want to add some more data to one of the sheets, you should be able to do that. So if I go to this 2022 and let's add something for this Southeast, which currently doesn't exist. So I'm gonna go 2022 and I'll add something here. And to keep this simple, I'll just copy this data and just paste it below. And let's just enter some sales amount here, 9999, for that to be obvious. So now I got this Southeast number for 2022, 9999. So if we go here, you can see currently for Southeast, that doesn't display because pivot tables don't auto refresh. So what I'll do, I'll go to pivot table analyze, refresh, and I'm gonna go refresh all. And here you go, you can see it automatically picks up on that data and it shows up in our pivot table. That's how we make pivot tables from multiple worksheets. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.